This is an MS-880, Asian reproduction. I'm gonna build it and record it. I'm gonna build it bolt by bolt.
Seals are in.
Bar studs are next. Threadlock, blue. I use blue on everything, everywhere. Maybe not everything, but everywhere I use it, I just use blue. I use double nut to get those in. Big old crankshaft. Thank you. I do this upside down so that the rod dangles in the opening for the cylinder. That way you don't get the con rod stuck over here if you're not paying attention.
I think. Let's get this off of there.
Moving on, go to the PTO side. I'm sorry, the flywheel side. Now, something I like to do. With the gaskets, just put a little coat of oil on them. It keeps them from gluing the case halves together if you ever have to pull the crankcase apart again for whatever reason. It works pretty good.
Let's see, I use just the
all around the edge, where the seal would go. You go all the way around the bolt holes. This is just 2-cycle oil. Oh yeah, something else you might want to do before we move on. Bring the case halves together. Be a good idea to install the oil tube, oiler pickup tube. Throw a little bit of lube or oil around the bottom of this, where this fits in, just before it slides into the case. This stuff, this Lucas assembly lube, is really slick. I mean, it makes this a rubber. Oh wow, I don't think I've ever seen one. Come here. It was bridged. Right there. That's interesting. I have to cut that out.
What did you go on with the cracker? Yeah. they still have Stihl back then?
Blue locked, right? I use the case bolts to draw the case halves together. That's just how I like to do it. Gotta be careful. Watch your crank. Make sure you're not pinching it, or your connecting rod. Make sure you're not pinching it when you're drawing them together. Draw them together real slow. Turn it a time. Make sure you stay even. Across your gap, and we'll use this one right here. Keep the front coming down. I hope I'm not forgetting something. I've never built one of these. I never actually had one apart, nor ever had to put one together. Be careful when you're drawing these case halves together. I've built just cut that bar. And take care of those tags. When you put them together, you're going to have them tags. Little ears left over.
Just take them.
I have one of these. X-Acto knife with a straight edge on the end of it.
It's nice to just
slide across. smooth.
So the old is an M20.
It's M25 or M28.
Shit.
Too late now. Now real quick, I ain't torquing down. Oh, that one was tight. Wow. This could be 28s. I don't know. Let's see. Those are 28. Alright, so this is considered a new style. A new style case. A 28mm crankcase. Screw. Millimeter crankcase screw. Oh, 10. Okay. 10 newton meters torque. Alright. That's not too bad. 10 newton meters. Let's set the torque wrench to 10 newton meters. Feeling you're supposed to put something right here. Alright, so after some investigating, I found what this little hole right there is, with the green behind it. I found out what that hole was for. The pump. A little knob on the back of the pump pokes through that hole. It's got silver rings. I have never seen silver rings in a socket before. Look at that piston. It is huge. Alright. All clean. And the Rocky Mountain range is gone from my intake manifold. Intake transfer ports. Yeah, what's... where yet? All nice and smooth. Let's get the rings on first. A faint, that's a faint arrow. So if you don't know, the arrow points toward the exhaust. So we move down. Did the bottom ring groove first. It's just easier for me to do it that way. And then the top one's just a quick snap. Try not to slide the sharp edge of the ring end down the piston. You can scratch it up. Probably not a huge deal, but it's ugly. It'll look like a score later on. Looks like I scratched it up. Scratch. Let's look at that. Let's do this. undo the... Again, the flywheel side is the easiest side to access with the wrist pin. The access, so we want the piston facing forward. We want the left side, the piston with the arrow pointing at you. You know, put the left side C clip in first, or G clip, but it looks like they're changing their ways and giving us some nice C clips. Ones that, oh hell. That one's already got one in it. Oh, interesting. And it's the right one. What the shit? Alright. Cool. I didn't put that in there. Let's get this lubed up. Looks like it's time to get some more oil out. Some oil on the bosses on the inside. Sounds nice and easy. Alright. Arrow toward the exhaust, where you should be looking at the front of the saw, the exhaust side of the saw. You know what I did last time to help steady this up. And if you've got these little blocks that I'm going to show you, they're pretty handy. Check them really quick. I'll pull the feeler gauge out and have a look at it. The distance between each side. It's a little too tight. It falls right down inside there. All right. Too many to push. Pushed a little bit. Not so tight. The weight is correct. Goosey goosey. Take out of it that time. Yep. All right. This other side, the flywheel side is fat, I can't tell. This thing is good though. got 16,000ths on either side. So I was saying, your little blocks are handy. Put down here, put your stop on there. It's gonna help us steady the piston when we're pushing on the C-clip. We gotta bib this up. I want the C-clip going down inside the crankcase. Like this. Maybe I can do it right here. Oh, I still got two. That's nice. If I lose one, I've got a spare. And the piston's incorrect. Alright. What's in there? Yep, she in there. Alright. Not so bad.
So we have a gander here. This thing.
Two pieces of tin foil, nice.
Funny, but these look like 5 millimeter.
Can't be 5 millimeter. 6 millimeter. They gotta be. Don't even need to use this thing. Oh yeah, I will. Because I gotta have room to get that out. This isn't gonna do me much good. Really, with that crankcase. Crankshaft. Coming straight up out of that. Up out of that case. Dang. I don't know if this thing's big enough. Let me get that ring in the right spot. Get back over there. Back to your room. Wow. Almost not big enough. Dang. Alright. Down. This one must be difficult. Done. Alright, so if you can't see what I'm doing here, I got my T-handle, it's got a hole in the side, and I'm just taking a little screwdriver and using it for just a little extra torque. Because I know 15 Newton meters, that's a healthy one. I'm just getting into tight. Well, that's pretty good, put a pretty good twist on this steel wrench. Alright. And I'm pretty sure the wrench will break before these screws break. Yeah, alright. Boy. Let's see if I can do this on its side. I can put a little more torque on them. First, let's put some resistance in there for us. This will be the first saw. I actually think I'm going to need a decompression or a comp release.
I haven't actually ever used one.
I think I'm going to need it. That 660 was a bear when I first put it together. Newton meters. The computer's in my brain there for a minute. Decompression valves, they're doing better. They ain't coming off real easy anymore. Alright. Even going to use their crappy ass piece of shit plug. It just don't work for steels. But it's a good warm-up plug. Good what you call break-in heat cycling plug. So when we're done heat cycling, we can go in the bin. You should have already, this is probably the only thing I'm really going to change right off the bat. I mean, I got to do some heat cycles with this plug. We'll start it up, idle it for a little while, That's how I do my break-ins. I heat cycle first. Heat cycle. And before I put a bar and chain on it, it's going to get a Bosch. I like the Bosch spark plugs. So it will get the WSR 6F. If you go to a saw shop and they hand you a WS 7F, throw it back at them. Tell them it's the wrong fucking plug. You need to have the WSR 6F. WSR 6F. The NGK works good too. The BPMR 7A. That'll work. I prefer Bosch. Just remember, if they give you a WS7F, that is a Husqvarna plug, give it back to them. Tell them it's the wrong plug. You do not want to put that plug in your... It's the exact same thing as these. That's what these are. And they're just too cold. They just don't... It runs rich. They're hard to tune. They are real pita. If you try to run this plug for too long. When it's broke in, that plug won't even work when it's broke in. We have all kinds of issues. So just first thing to do is just get rid of it. You know what? Before I get too further, let's do some cleanup, some housekeeping. Flywheel. And the flywheel canut. How much torque is that supposed to have? Deep groove. Boy. Dang, that can't be right. Okay. Yeah. That's it right there. That is. She home. Well, that's tight. No playing in that one. I don't know, these funky bent washers, these spring washers, spring lock washers, whatever the hell they are. I put them raised side up. I don't know, I never. Oh, put some Loctite on this guy. Need some Loctite over here. And right here, I'd say a healthy serving is warranted. What size is that? That can't be a 13. That ain't a 13. That, I'll bet. It's a 15. Alright, found a socket. I'm gonna use an impact. On its first setting, should be like 60. So if I just tap it a couple times, and I got the line pressure turned down to 65 PSI, so shouldn't get the whole, I think it's 80 foot-pounds is what that puts there, so that shouldn't put out 80 foot-pounds. So it's a little overkill right here, but my butterfly, the little butterfly ain't gonna put out enough to lock that sucker on there. That's what I usually use to put flywheel on the smaller saws. But this is a 17 millimeter, by the way, 17 millimeter socket, and I got an impact. I do have the correct socket. It just is too fat to fit inside over there. Boy, that was really low. There we go. Alright, flywheel's on. I feel confident that was at least 45 foot-pounds. So this thing's got a lot of compression. Yeah, I'm gonna need compression release on this one. I ain't even gonna pretend. Not even gonna pretend that I can pull that over without a compression release. At least not until it's broken. Oh yeah. Next thing. I don't know about anybody else, but I really like putting my, initials or, some kind of identification in here. I like that they're blank. They don't come with just a random 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 set of numbers. So I'm going to stamp mine with this little number set I got. Real quick, like. But you can put whatever you want there. These are really cheap. I got these on eBay. Maybe Amazon. It might have been Amazon. I think they were like $5. $6. Something like that. And I got a set of numbers with them. Alright. We're back. And I'm pretty sure I got what I need. Why did you do that? Flex and chicks and shit. Hell. Okay, so the oil pump goes down and I like that. Oh, we need one of those grommets. Alright. Alright, so for the oil pump, we got one of those really little round chunk of hose looking things, and they're in here somewhere, hopefully. If not, I got extras. I did think ahead for that. Oh, there it is right there. Alright, that's the little one we need right there. All right. Whatever the f this is, 16. A cover. Okay. Spur gear. Skirt. Am I missing anything? Don't look like it.
Ooh, Loctite.
Oh shoot! I almost lost that guy. Let's go ahead and stick this down in there.
That goes right there. Right here. No. You can see it. Right there. Right here.
It's getting heavy. It's getting heavy. Alright, let's put some lubes on those. It's just for shits and giggles. Come on out there.
Alright, now blue lock types.
Cover. What the F is this cover covering? Go back to my kill. Covers this gear? Is that what it's doing? This guy go on first. I need some lubes.
Interesting. Oh, look at that.
Cool.
And then a color. Hold on. Color goes here. Like so. This. No. This. And this goes on over. This.
So this little gear here that spins the oil pump, that's gotta go on first. Put that in there. Make sure she spins good. She does. Your cover goes on next. Spur gear goes on next with some lubes. Needs lubes this side. Come on. Just a little bit of lubes on that oil light bushing. And then, you know, I'm gonna have to put a little bit of lubes on these teeth. I don't imagine. Never hurt nothing. Just a little bit. This stuff. Stuff is awesome. I like this Lucas assembly lube. It is stringy. Slick. Super slick. Like snot. Slick like snot. Alright, there we go. Oh, that's all. Together. Oh, wait, click. Yeah, I said, look at three screws going. Wow, I got three screws left. Alright, there we go. Tights. Lock tights. More lock tights. I don't know. I really need to put that. Yeah, I gotta put that on. I got to put the clutch on. Yep. Gotta put that on. Can't put it on after the clutch.
Up in there. Well, come on. There we go. Alright.
So we got our clutch pieces here. These are intake pieces, but I don't understand. But whatever. Put them there for now. Gonna move this right now. And our drum bearing right there. This. Oh boy. This is killed. All right, cheating again. It's a 21 millimeter, or I think that's 13/16. So let's see what the caliper says. That's not 21 millimeters, 22. Okay, so it's that didn't work. I have to measure the actual. Oops. 13/16. Yes, that was correct. 13/16. I forgot to say loud noises coming and coming. All right, so I just resolved my first issue with this saw. When I put the clutch on and torqued down, it was locking the worm drive was getting pinched. And what I did was just took some sandpaper and a flat surface and just sanded it down until it stopped pinching it. I'd take quite a bit off. Let's see. You guys can see how much. It's pretty thin. I don't know why it was such a pinch. But, issue resolved. Alright, chain break time. Whee! Love chain breaks. Hardware. This bag contains all your brake hardware and two small E-clips. So be careful when you dump it out. You're going to have two small E-clips to watch for. I'll handle the brake handle too. do a quick test fit, make sure the plastic fits, and it appears to fit. Is that raised up like that? Is that not falling down into a, something it's supposed to fall down into? Is there another issue? Going down inside that spot right there. Why does it get fat like that? Okay. That's, I don't know. It's raised up. Let's see what the bar plate does. Have a look at it, see. Oh, that's a heavy bar plate, damn. I suppose cranking the bar down is going to correct whatever issue there is. No, it nearly is touching it. Okay. So, let me do some more investigating. It looks like there's something funky with this guy. I'm going to have to fix. Very minor issue with this chain brake cover here. The plastic is really thick right here in this corner. You have to take and carve a little bit of that out, or sand a little bit of it, whichever you like. That's it. I'll let it sit down inside there like it's supposed to. And it won't push your bar plate out. So, solved. Moving on. Let's see how the brake fits. Mm-hmm. These are always fun to install. Because they're never bent right. Surprisingly, not too bad. It's in there pretty good. Let's see. You get the drum. It's a little. Need some adjustment over here. I think. Might need to be spread out a little bit more. Oh, there we go. Looks like that issue resolved itself. Let's check it. Make sure. That's the bad part about this is you can't see where the daggum doohickey bobber here is. Maybe right there. No. Good spot to see that thing. I guess just line up that slot right there. Best thing to do.
this on here. Alright. I'd have to spread that out a little bit. 044 I put together was kind of the same way. A little tight here and there. Make sure it's pushed down. Everywhere it needs to be pushed down and out, everywhere it needs to be out. Fit down on there, not the most graceful. Rubbing pretty hard on the backside right here. Let's see if I can adjust that. Maybe. A little rubbing here and there is not an issue, not a huge issue. I can turn it by hand, but it's enough to annoy me. Let's see what I can do to rectify this situation. Bit of a strange kink right here. Just gotta bend that back out. I'll have to take this back apart. Yeah, because that almost fixes the situation. Popping out where it needs to be. It's a little tighter than I like. A little rub don't bother me, but... Oh, wow. Okay, pushing it all the way back. Well, then that might not be an issue. Let's see what happens. Just pushing that all the way back out like that. Good. Let's see. Around. Alright. You know what? I get this in there first. Dang, this is the second time I've done that. Get out of there. Oh wait, I can get that in there without... You know what? I'm not gonna be able to get. Maybe I can. We'll see. If I can get the... on there. Cook in the grease. Cook in the grease. Come on. Stop. There we go. Did I just put that on with my freaking finger? Okay, there we go. Well, it did go on with my finger, though. Alright. Now for this bastard's little spring. This thing. Right there. Do I want to go under it?
Yeah, I want to go under it. Sometimes I want to go under.
Let me see if I can
picture this for you.
I'm the wrong way.
Okay. So I'll point this out for you. This. Turning white. Quit turning white. Alright. So, right up. That spring right there. Sometimes I want to go over that arm, sometimes I want to go under it. So, just kind of look at the way the spring, when you put it on, it'll point up. You need to flip it over.
If it sticks straight up. And it should go on this little arm really easy.
So I don't know if we can see this or not. So I can bring this up so you can see it. See how that's on there? It's going under it instead of over the top.
Throw some greases on this little half moon shaped thing on there, or the handle. It's the locator for the clutch arm, clutch handle. And then we need this piece. Let's put this rubber boot over this right here. Probably somewhere in the middle. Because the spring's gonna go this way. Reach over to that arm, pull on that leather. So in the middle or up here, actually was closer to the clutch thing here. Let's put it up there. That way with vibration it doesn't touch it. Put it a little closer. Let's put it there.
Yeah. So on this spring you want this piece of rubber hose almost reached the end of the spring, the coils, where it almost contacts the clutch housing.
And this goes in.
Yeah, this funny link deal here. Go in your brake handle like this. Like so.
What?
Yeah, like this. Sorry, find it backwards. Goes in like this. What's this little thing right here? So this one, I can't do it on its side. I have to tip it up. Oh, maybe. Maybe I can prop it with something. Try to do it one-handed. Let me throw some more grease out here. Thank you.
Something slightly stouter. No, 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 don't come over there. Stay. Oh, you know what? I'm gonna have to. Oh, wait, hold on. I can cheat it.
So, let me take this back off. Reset. Alright. So this part down here, has to go inside this band first. However, you gotta get it in that band. There we go. Right there. Put this in here. Get that over there. And then push. There. It's a trick. You gotta do all these things at once. Oh, no. Go back in. Stay. Alright. Alright. Get on there. Alright. All right, so the trick, right on there. Well, mostly, got the spring. Yeah. Oh, okay, well, snapped that into place, excellent. All right,
so this is what it's gonna look like when it's all done. Three things you gotta do all at once. This arm goes back inside here. You gotta fit this inside this handle and over this peg in the middle of it. Come on, stop going. There. All the while, trying to fit down on this pin at the same time and keeping it in this band. Gotta do all three of those things at the same time. All right, now that it's mostly together, we can put this bastard spring on. It's usually not too difficult if you've done a couple of them. Let me find a little trick. Hopefully I can show it, but I don't know if this isn't going to want to. This thing has to pop back off there. Man, I really need to prop this up somehow. Because that handle, if I push this down, that handle is going to want to push back. I guess I can put the recoil assembly on. Let me do that real quick. Throw a screw in it. Just to keep that brake handle from getting pushed off.
These are all the same size. Should be.
All right. Come on, get up there. There. Now, tip it on its side without it. Throw a screw in here real quick. Man. Take it some more. Wacky on me. Oh well. All right, so this spring attaches back here and reaches up into here. And it's down. It's tight. Back because it's gonna get, yeah, because it only goes forward. So it's easier to start it on this side and bring this back over here. And it takes I'll take a big screwdriver, some medium-sized screwdriver. Why is that so bright? So this is what I take the blade of the screwdriver, reach it in the spring. This one might need to be a little bit smaller screwdriver. I have to use a smaller. But just take it, reach it over, and lever it over to that peg. This peg right here. And this, it gets interesting, especially when springs start flying out everywhere. And I have a little tool that does this, so I should put a glove on. Maybe get a paper towel ready in case it snaps off. It doesn't feel good when it snaps you. If it slips, there we go. Slipped. There we go. Shorter, stouter, or equally stout. It has a narrow blade on it, so just slide over it easy, hopefully. That was better. Have to get it down. Ah, there we go. Got it. Okay. Oh, my rubber worked all the way back. Push it forward. There we go. Yeah. Right there. All right. All together. Ugh, she's stiff. Yeah. All right. Yeah. That should make it easier to put the drum back on. Windy rubbing. Oh yeah, just drop that down in there, easy peasy. Yep. Right, put the rim on. Hang on. No. Okay. You know what? That's fine. I can put that. Push this down. All right. Ooh, almost forgot. Boy, that was bad. That could have been real bad. Got that E-clip. Alright. E-clip is on there. And it works. Rag debris down there. Yeah. She locked up tight. Alright. Push that back down in there. Bring it back in Disney. Back. And this back. Hang this back up. Put that back down all the way. Keep that thing handy. I need that. Big old E-clip. It's tight. Yeah. Like no rubbing whatsoever. That's nice. We'll put our cover back and cover on right here. Worked out nicely.
nicely. And it's 2 4x12s. Two of these guys. Tights. Shake it. Shake it. Separate. Oh man, getting low. That is getting.
Those ain't 3.5.
4.12. Yeah, they are.
4.12.
In plastic, maybe not. I forgot the one down here on the brand, on a band. So I'm going to pull out another more 4x12. And that brake band. Moving along. AV, are we at that point? Maybe we should put the muffler on. I guess we could put the muffler on. Muffler. Let me see. Where are we at? So, cool thing about this muffler is it's stainless steel. It's pretty cool. Using stainless, and it's really, really heavy. Really heavy. But I don't know if you can see this strange situation here. The exhaust has to go through this screen, across the inside here, and there's a little built-in tube, and comes out right here. I don't know if you can see inside there. Tiny little hole. Tiny. So, and then this is a big-ass exhaust port. And that little tiny hole. I'm not going to mount this right away. Like I said, I'm going to just run it, stick it in some wood, and just get it broken as far as I can before I come back and mod it.
port, muffler mod, probably not going to play with the timing. There's not enough slop on that crank, between the crankshaft and the flywheel to really advance, and I'm not doing no cutting on the flywheel or the crank. I guess I could shim down or skinny up the woodruff key. Done that before, but not interested in advancing the timing. This thing's gonna be a bitch to start as it is. So let's look. Find out what a collar stud is. This thing. Stihl calls a collar stud. I don't know if you can. It's 5 millimeter on one side, and it's 6 millimeter on the other side. Screws into the case, muffler fits over it, and then use 5 millimeter nuts to fasten. There we go, right there. Of course, not without Loctite first. Borrow my little adapter here. Oh, what is the torque? Don't go away. Torque on those. Collar stud crank 12 newton meters. Okay. Now it says 6 by 30. It don't say 5 by 6 by 30 like it should. There's three different dimensions. They're 30 millimeters long overall. Yeah, six, like I said, the 6 millimeter thread on one side, a 5 millimeter thread on the other. Use a 10 millimeter socket. Drive them in. Boy, this thing don't hold on to shit. This is a snap-on? Maybe the socket, this torque wrench does suck. Let's just blame the damn sockets. That little gear is just not very big. What? 12. Fig Newtons. Back and some drink. Try this again. Oh hell.
It says 16s.
I had those 16s.
Oh, I think I messed up. These
should have used those. I think. Yep, those ones I should use. Gosh darn it. Let's just take them back out. Put them back in that bag. What a journey that was. Jeez.
No, yeah, I better put some Loctite on those. I'm supposed to use them. Okay. So, if you can see, these lock nuts have a metal in them rather than a plastic. Those are what you use for the muffler. The bottom of the muffler. And it's probably an 8mm. 10.4 it is. We should probably put some Loctite on these. Just even though they are their own locking mechanisms, what is not gonna hurt? Certainly not gonna hurt. Oh yeah, these do have a nice thread lock on them. Go with 10 on these as well. The muffler. You know what I did? I forgot. And I can't sneak it in right now. I'm not gonna do it right now. Fuck it. I'll do it later. The foil on the top of the tank. Top of the whole tank. Okay. Then take part and go back in that box. This part and go back. Oh, it's kind of plastic. Wow. Rubbery plastic. Anti-vibe. Annular anti-vibe. This goes in my handle. I don't need that right now. Back in the box. But this is anti-vibe. Anti-vibe. Another anti-vibe. And a... Aha! I know where that bump top goes. I can see it. Why am I? So what's this? Just a little bit. Goes a long ways with this rubber. Just get it around there. Kind of a fast one. Let me find some sort of a suitable push tool. Perfectly sized screwdriver would be great. It's too big to fist down the side. I guess we can just push it over the thumbs. It's got the grease. So that's good. Let's put this. This bitch. Let's keep that in.
in there before I forget about it. Nightmare. Tiny little hole, great big ass piece of rubber. Not a fun job. And this stuff don't do a whole lot to help. Not on this one. A whole lot of stuff. Okay, let's go onto that floor. Where's your meal? Yeah, this one's a bitch. Start pushing it in, it just popped right out. Shit, steel engineers are laughing their asses off at me. That's why we have this tool. That's what this tool was designed to do. Success. That wasn't so bad, really. So this little annular I just put in here, or bump stop, is right there. Oh, you can't really see it right there. It's not pointy. It's pointy on the other side. Over this side. That's the pointier side. That's the side that goes inside the case. So flat. The flat point goes, well, toward the tank, I guess. That's how that one goes in. Any vibe on that side is done. Well, wait a minute. We got this here. This on quick. Find out what screws we need. A little bit of oil. Oh, balancing a little more. There you go. Just run it around. Right there, like that. Right down here. And this thing just pop right in. That lube is amazing. This one's gonna need a lot of lube everywhere. That's really sticky. Lube everywhere on this one. All corners on the back side. Right there. I probably got too much. But it's kind of a pain because it's really... Oh, wow. That was not a pain at all. Take and just poke it through. Make sure you got all the way in. Just wipe the oil off. The AV system. Gosh, I'm just about ready to put the tank on. I'm not ready for those yet. Tank's gotta go on. So those are after the tank. Down there. Are we ready for the tank? Are we ready for the tank? Nope. I wanna get my intake boot on. This locates right here on the side. That's pretty nifty. I'm going to tell you about where the boot goes. Okay. Alright. Gooey boot. Oh man. That matches the intake port pretty well. It do match the intake pretty well. I need my clamp. Let's see. Looks like he can go up. Oh, why is it? It's collapsed. Why did they collapse it? Like, completely collapsed. It's actually... This boot, or this clamp looks pretty well constructed. The little nut on the end's captured. Just barely fits. Dang. It's gonna be the squeeze. And then tighten this screw back up. Don't think they need to go straight back together. It's pretty solid. Leave like, oh, I don't know, less than a quarter, more than an eighth in between there, where the two parts connect, they're gonna touch. It's tight. It's really tight, so it don't need to be any tighter than that. I like that boot. That's nice. And now, this thing has got something. It's got something.
Some kind of something. I think I know what it is. Oh wow, how nice. I didn't see this. Some flashing. So another something to look out for. This little piece of plastic don't belong there. You gotta cut that out.
This animal is gonna get tore up. This gets pulled through. Maybe. Don't break. Break. Don't break. I should have put a little bit of oil on it.
Resistances. All right. That was not easy, and I hope you've seen that, because I'm not gonna take it apart to show you again. Keep an eye on this rubber buffer in here. It can get tore really easy on this little finger that slides in it. It's got a little notch that stands up. You got to get that. That's the critical spot right there. Everything else just kind of slid into position. All I got to do is screw it together now. It's tight, man. It's tight in here. There's no way. You know, you reach in there and put that impulse hose in there. I mean, maybe. You might be able to reach it from right here with a pair of needle nose. You can probably reach it right there with a pair of needle nose. But, that was too tight. That's the way to do it. Put the impulse hose on first and just kind of feed it through into the card box and focus on this is going to give you some resistance. The boot, the car boot will give you some resistance, and then I guess watch this annular right here. This is going to be the biggest pain in the ass to get the little notch slot machine thing in there without tearing that up. And that's all we gotta do is put screws in it. Find out what kind of screws we need. I think those are gonna be plastoform up there. And we got brass inserts in the back. And then we got some monster screw that goes right. That can't be a monster screw. 30 millimeter? Okay. Need this and this little funny looking thing that goes in this deal on this side.
IPL old that they switched some shit on me.
Yeah, because that's not Del Taffer. That's in the back there.
That was a threaded insert. So that's got to be something else to remember. This... The IPL that I have is older than my saw. So... I'm going to have to find out. Do a count. Go back and look and see what I got. Because there's... something. There's an issue here. So I got to figure it out. Alright, so here's what I decided to do. I'm going to use these two. They come in package all by themselves. Just two. They are the self-tappers. They're 18 millimeter long. Or almost 18 millimeter. They're really close. Those go up front on either side of the tank mount up here. And that's where I'm going to put these two right now. Get that taken care of, and then I can work on... where those threaded, the 6mm machine thread screws are going to go after I take care of these. Alright, that looks good. It's seated. Make sure it's turning the grommet. You want to be careful with these. They call them plastoform, or so the self-tappers. They go in real tight, and you really can't tell at what point they bottom out. It's kind of difficult. So you just got to go slow with them. I mean, it's a very, very slight increase in resistance. But you can... you can strip them right out. Easy money. Not paying attention. Yeah, that one's in there. Yeah. That one's tight. Alright, and then this one back here. It's a 6mm. One of these. There's three of these in a package. 6mm. See how long they are. They look like they're 19-20mm. 19.5. So these three are 19.5mm. 6mm diameter. I'm going to use one right here in the back. Of course, it's going to get some tight. Some resistance, so you're going to have to... go in. Yeah, they went in. And this one should be obvious when it bottoms out. So that's tight. Spinning the grommet. That's how you know when you're up against the grommet and you're tightening it. You don't want to over-tighten it. That's always bad. Okay. Now, that's the main... three on the bottom, and then you've got this guy on the side up here up top, which is also... boy, maybe I can move it better. Oh jeez, it seems to really work. I can move that. Yeah, I can. Ah, there we go. So we'll leave those tight. So that's something to keep in mind also. Install these three at the same time, the screws. Install this one piece all at one time after you get the tank together. I might have had an easier time getting the tank together or attach the block if this was off. Like I said, this piece goes right here. Kind of like that. It's like a little limiter, I guess. Goes right there, but I gotta find out what length of screw that takes. And then that goes right here through this little silver standoff keeper catcher, whatever the hell they call it. So that goes. So let's get some Loctite on it. Loctite. Ooh. Got a lot of Loctite on this screw on accident. It's mostly loose, and it's just sitting there. Like I said, make sure when you're putting this together, and you're putting the annular or the AV system together, put this one on last after you have the tank together. It'll be a little bit easier to install the whole thing. I think it would be easier to install the tank that way. I don't know. It really didn't seem like it was giving me any fits, really. It was that buffer on the side, the rubber buffer on the side that was, it's got the slot that it's supposed to fit into. And you can tighten all these up, put these back to where they were. So this is good. I was worried about it. You know, I didn't want it to distort the carb box. And that was my main concern, but having to push that down to make that hole line up. But everything, really, I haven't had to really force any kind of, I haven't had to force anything together. Everything went together pretty good. And then these two screws, I don't know. Oh, sure there's a use for them somewhere. But the AV system's complete now. You start working on the carburetor. See, they got, there's washers in the bag, but there's also washers on the screws themselves. I'm pretty sure those are the coil screws. So the new style, the new cases. And I gotta go underneath the coil to pick, to lift the coil up. More Loctite. and I use two business cards to get my air gap. Unless you have that special handy dandy little tool that works pretty well. I don't, so I just use two business cards, get the thick air gap that I need. Okay, you can go on in. Pretty tight. This goes up here. This one goes in here. Is that how it goes? They both gotta go in that little channel. See, since it fits, it's gotta go in that little channel. Okay, so here's what I got so far. Let's see where I got. This wire routed around behind, this one comes around beside it. I put the kill wires under the ignition lead, the spark plug wire. That's how I got those routed. I'll work on the carb side of the routing. There's these grommets I had mentioned earlier. I have to fit right here. Let's rotate these so that they're more better. And this one goes down here. These go on those little channels made just for them. And this grommet goes right here. Maybe just for it. Is that how it's gonna go, or is it? I got that one up there backwards. Maybe? No? No, that looks good. Maybe I got them back. I'm gonna try to flip it over. It looks like it has a lip to seal with the card. No? The same, no matter which way it faces, it's the same. Alright. So then, down their perspective slots. Alright. So, get this a little closer for you. See where those wires go. That's how I have them wired up. Now, it's a carp show. Let's get these in here before we forget about them. I don't know which is which. Now there's a sleeve, metal, little metal ring thing. This is the sleeve right here. Metal called sleeve. This goes over this impulse line. I'm gonna have to use some lube on that because it's tight. Still don't want to slide around. To go behind that, right there, yeah, I would imagine that's what that's for. Okay. This, go over this, so, and this, oops, I don't know, maybe this just goes on the end and it pushes in, I don't know. Strange. Hmm.
so bad. I'll move it back a little bit. This is sliding forward. Okay, let's try that. Get it started. Then we'll use the sleeve. Slide it on. Yeah. Tricky. Got it. Oh, I do not like that kink in that fuel line. Jeez. Baloney. I got a better design for that.
Okay, so I'll show you what I'm doing with this thing I'm calling a sleeve. See on the top of the carburetor that shiny silver piece next to the brass? They call that a sleeve. And you slide that back about a quarter of an inch past the end of the hose, and then you grab the sleeve and push the sleeve onto that nipple, and then use the sleeve only and just push it forward. I had to put it in lube on it. Some assembly lube, because it didn't want to move. So be careful. I use needle nose pliers. You don't want to puncture or tear that line. It's pretty pliable, but I wouldn't test it too far. I wouldn't push it too far. So, let's do the throttle. It looks like it's going to be the most pain in the ass. Well, I can't really show you what I'm doing with the throttle and the choke cables or wires. It's something you're just going to have to struggle through on your own. It works very well. Doesn't close all the way. Probably closes enough to make it choke anyways. Loosen enough of it. Let's see what happens when it gets all bolted together.
Where's it binding? Why?
Okay. Let's put this handle back on.
Stiff, but it's functioning. Working. Crazy. Crap stuff.
plugs. So those can go. And this, if I can put that in the oil tank now. Get ready for that. And those. Another car part. And, yeah. Let's... Plate. Oh, you know what? I got something to do to this before I forget. It's something I do to all my saws. And while I have it out and accessible, let's see, what's this? Is this going all the way around? Put that on the car really quick. Like it's on there. Try to tuck it in a little better, maybe. Yeah. Tucking it in. It's nice. Sick little. Yeah. Okay. So this, I'm going to do here, where, ha, foam tape, on that layer, get the foam tape down, this stuff is super good sticky stuffs, it, like once you put it down, it ain't coming up.
I'm going to shoot trace. Oh, okay. I can follow that around. All right. Give me something to follow. Which side? Oh, wait. That side's got it. Actually, that would be better if I just trace this out. The edge of the foam tape doesn't go past that line. Try that again. This guy around. Let's follow this thing around. Laying that down. It's pretty pliable. You can pull on it quite a bit and move it around. It's a lot of, it's a rubber foam, I think. Stuff it down in there. I think that's about what it needs to be.
Let's rub it down really good. Push it down. Like I said, this stuff is sticky. Once you get it down, you're just gonna tear the foam up trying to get it off. It's gnarly. This is stuff I got off eBay or Amazon. $5, I think, for 30 feet, and I've used a lot of it.
This will sit down there. Push it down there, you can see it'll leave. It looks like I got it.
Then I use a double nut system to drive that, to tighten that up, snug it up. That back. Oh wait, better put this on before I lose sight of it. Okay. Finagle it. And then push it in.
Push in. It's firm. It's like hard plastic. Rubbery plastic almost.
This is an interesting one. There we go. Snap in there. That's gonna work.
I do see some empty bores.
Bad. So there's a reason I put the recoil on assembly last. Well, second to last, just before the handlebar. Handlebar would be absolutely last. So when you're building and you're messing around with the saw, and you got these magnets, and they will suck up every dang thing you get close to them. And if you don't pay attention, and they got something on them, and you go to start it, and it gets in here, and it starts flying around, it'll destroy that coil in a second, and then it'll die, and then you won't know why. Until you start to take it apart, and then you'll see the carnage, and it ruins the flywheel too. So I always put the recoil cover on last, unless I have to have it on to put the top shroud on, which I believe the 361 is that way. You have to have this recoil cover on to get the top cover right. So unless that's the case with this, I'm going to leave the recoil assembly off until the very last. Put my head in the picture again. Alright. What next? Let me look here. I guess we could assemble the brake. Not the brake, the bar plate. Chain tensioner. This goes in here somewhere. Get that part of it done. Get the side case on, the bar plate on, so I can still turn this on the side, yeah. Put that on the side, like so. Like that. It should be nice and free spin. A fairly free spin, just like that. You don't want it to drag on the brake band in there. Something's wrong if it's dragging. I'm just touching it. Yeah. I mean, it spins pretty freely. That's what you want. That's the aim. All right, let's get this chain tensioner open. This one's a little different. Got some other goodies in it. Extra goodie. A little bit different goodie. Looks, man, it looks nice. I mean, that's like the best friggin' chain tensioner I've seen come out of Farmer Tech. That it's really almost OEM. The gears are definitely hardened. Good. And this, I don't know that. And these, boy, remember when these first things came out from Farmer Tech, right there, that cover, they were like tin foil. You could just like, bink, bend them. This thing's solid. Definitely more than tin foil. Maybe 410 foil. I don't know. It's pretty strong. It's not easy to bend, for sure. Look at the IPL real quick. Let's put this down. Put some lubes. Greases. Need some greases for this one. Wash it down with a rubber. Doohickey Mababa. Tamp it down. Make sure it's all the way down to the base. Alright, that's all the way down. And this goes over it. Feels pretty good. Then this piece.
So this goes this way. That goes on the outside. The double thing goes on the inside.
And this bent washer goes over the big gear. Let me throw some grease on there. Grease the situation up a little bit. Alright. Got greases on it. Then this plate goes over the top. All right, and this piece goes over the top.
Okay, so it's got pointy things. So those face up, like little cleats. Those need to go up. I guess it can't go the other way. So never mind.
And you got your little pan flathead screw. A little bit of Loctite, a little bit of Loctite in the hole. Okay, a lot of Loctite in the hole. Screw down tight.
Nice. Very nice. Until we get to right there. Okay.
Might need some adjustment.
little smidge. Nah. That's a long-winded girl. Greases on that screw. And in there, all over. Some greases for the screws. Tight right there. I'm gonna have to move it forward a little bit. All right. Skew. And that should be in. One of these in here. There's maybe that hex. Maybe that one. I don't think I can think of. She is. Maybe. Oh. Oh. Dogs. God dog it. Gotta take that out. Put the dogs in. Boy, that locked up nice. Imagine this thing probably vibrates a lot. I don't know. I've never actually had the privilege of running one when I was working in the saw shop. With dogs right here, and there's some kind of a deflector. What is this shit? Deflector of some kind. This piece right here, it goes right here. Yes, it goes right there. Okay, but it fits over something. What keeps it in? What keeps it there? A screw. A screw keeps it there? Huh? Or the dog? Yeah, the dog fits on over here. So, okay, so it fits on it. Oh, okay. I see. It fits on the dog. It fits over the dog. So, oh, those were loose. Oh, I got a trick for y'all on those. This one loose? Wow, okay. Okay. Right there. So,
nuts on the outside. Let your nuts hang out. Okay, I'm gonna show you this trick with these things real quick. It's gonna help anybody who owns a Stihl and buys farmer tech. So you take scissors, cut a little square out, about 3/4 by, I don't know, half, something like that. Cut you a little square of plastic. Place your piece of plastic. Let me see. I'm gonna move this a little bit out of the way. So you got your side cover thing, and you got these little plastic guides. They always, for some reason, PharmaTech hasn't figured out how to get them tight. So to get them tight, you take that piece of plastic and you smash the thing down inside there, and she gonna be nice and tight. Ouch. Smash my finger. Yeah. Gonna be nice and tight. Yeah, she's gonna be nice and tight. And I stay. I don't come out. Escape. I think this is some kind of escape artist. Alright. And then the canut. Yeah, buddy. Oh my goodness. So awesome. And this one. It's got to go on like this. Goes here. Deliver that out. Like so. Oh yeah. Look at that. 2, 6. Those are too big. Well, this one's not. Maybe not. Okay. Oh. Okay. Nut goes on the other side. This goes there like that. And then the other canut, there it is. Alright.
to the...
Oh boy, those are sharp. That's gonna suck. That's sharp on the edge, not... Not sharp on the tip. Well, except for that one. It's sharp there too, but... Boy. Got like a knife edge on the other side. I'm gonna have to invest in some bigger, better dogs. I mean, not bigger, but better. Those are pretty big. Now the saw gets dangerous. Now we can put the bar plate on. Alright.
Should we lock tech that again? I think so. Puked Loctite all over the place. Come on, gotcha. Went in earlier. What's your problem?
This can go on next. Chain catcher. Ah, okay. Must be that other lock nut. But there wasn't a nut in that kit. That's strange. This one? Say yes.
That's gonna. That's gonna fuck it. Ouch.
OCD, man, is a bitch. Holy. I can't believe that. Them motherfuckers don't want to bend. Those are not shitty dogs. Alright, let's gotta fucking get it off. Ouch.
Actually bending this piece like I was trying earlier. That's the best thing. It's the only thing that'll bend. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Bam. Okay. Oops.
We're almost there. I almost got a saw. Hi. Been recording for a minute.
I guess this goes on a sander. Something like this. Yeah. I'll have to describe it. Oh yeah, okay. It goes like that. Goes like that. Oh, okay. Okay. Nifty. Stud. That little stud is right here. This must be the one that fits down in there.
So it bottoms out.
It's not segmented. What the hell? That's just gonna go all the way down. Let's undo this one. Come down. There we go. That was a long one. No way. Back. I really do need more of a screw. What the fuck? How am I supposed to get in here? Really? Crazy tight. Jeez. Well, the top cover's getting solid now, but the... I'm gonna put the recoil assembly on. Make sure we don't have any hitchhikers down here. Looks good. Oh, and then we need to make a quick repair to the recoil assembly. If you notice, this is how it came to me. Just like that. If you see the problem? Yeah, the nubs aren't inside the springs. So we gotta... Both of them are like that, so. Let's see what happens. Oh, surprising. It fits right up to that thing perfectly. Wow. Oh, my fingertips are blown. They hurt so bad. Twisting and turning screws. I still got a handlebar to put on. And then my air filter. Come on. Just going down. There you Three little screws left. I'm gonna keep my hair now. Alright. Set up enough to put. Beast mode. Friggin' beast mode, man. And diddly bar. Okay. Ah, there we go.
Oh, I hope these aren't too long. I guess I can check them really quick. Oof, darn it. Alright, that was gonna happen. Damn. I should have just wrenched it in there. Nation going on here. I'm not a fucking punch at the tank. Oh, that'll piss me off. There it is. There's the beast. Boy, she's heavy. Heavy girl. Alright. There it is. It's done. 880. Let's put the bam. Let's throw some dogs on her. Oh, this chain's a long. Dang. From this side it looks like it's a mile long. Cool.
Such a beast.